What's up, everybody? Pile 702 back today with another unregulated Squonker kit review. You all remember the Wasp Nano? Did a review for it. I'll put it right there. This right here is the Wasp Nano SQUONK kit by Oumier. I like Oumier, so I'm gonna say Oumier. How did I get this? This was, I told you, on holidays. Anytime there's a holiday, it means there's a sale. Now, Heaven's Gift, like any holiday pretty much that ever happens, is always 30% off. So I bought this Memorial Day from Heaven's Gift. I'll tell you how cheap I got it. I got it for really, really cheap. But so I've had this thing since basically the end of May, beginning of June. So I know it very, very well. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go downtown. I'm gonna show you all around this kit, put a build in it, listen to some tunes, pop back up, pros, cons. You know how we do it. Oumier Wasp Nano BF Mod. Now, before we look at this, the reason I bought this is I just searched around a lot on YouTube. I really didn't see any reviews for this at all. There might be like one or two. So we need a review. So let's check it out. On the front, you have your color scheme right here. Shows you what the Squonker is gonna look like. Bottom, you got your Oumier.com. On the side, Wasp Nano SQUONK kit, scratch and sniff. And then right there, it says Oumier Wasp Nano Mech SQUONK kit. No, this is not a mech squonker. This is an unregulated squonker. Oumier, you need to learn the difference between a mech and a unregulated squonker. On this side, we're gonna have you pause for a second so you can read all this, except for one thing. All the way down here, they promise you a warming card. So I thought I was gonna get some type of Hallmark card or something, like with something sweet written in it, but I didn't get my warming card. So let me know if you guys got your warming card. But other than that, that's everything you get. Back of the box, and pause. And we're good. Upon opening your Oumier Wasp Nano unregulated SQUONK kit, you will first have your user's manual. Let's see here. This is really all the specs you're gonna wanna kinda zero in on. It's got the size, the weight. Voltage range, this is gonna go all the way down to 3.2 before it shuts off, and the max is 4.2. On your resistance of your build, it's 3 ohms all the way down to 0.15. It's a 1 amp USB charging. And once again, mode, mech mode, that is bullshit. This is not a mechanical squonker. There are protections, there's reverse battery protection. There is a actual amperage protection. I tested it. I didn't bring an RDA to test it for you, but I did put a very low build dual coil RDA on this and it would not fire. So their protections on this unregulated mod actually work. You get your USB. And can you vape it while you're charging? I don't know, because I don't check that, because I think that's stupid. So I don't know. Look it up, but there's your USB. Oumier is joining the club of giving us these little battery protection cards, showing you that you shouldn't use batteries if they're tortoise shit. I mean, I think everyone kind of knows that. And if you have a battery that looks like that and you're using it, well, I'm gonna just say I told you so. Now on the back, I don't know if this is proper English. Caution, we Shallant?
Is shallant a word?
We shallant be responsible for any damages caused by using substandard battery. So
they shallant be responsible. Just remember that.
So don't use any batteries that look like this. Make sure your batteries look like this.
Always battery safety.
In your little extra bag, you get your baby blue screwdriver, some O-rings, you get a spaced single coil, and some extra little grub screws in there. They do not tell you anything about this coil. Don't know what it's made of. Don't know what it's supposed to ohm out to. I mean, it appears to be a spaced, I guess that's a, yeah, spaced fuse Clapton.
They also give you a nice little wad of cotton,
which we will not be using, but it's nice that they actually give you everything that you need. So when you buy this thing, you can literally, as long as you have a battery and e-juice, you're in business. So big ups on them for doing that. They do get a thumbs down though for not telling me what kind of coil that is. I think everybody should put the material of the coil. Obviously, it makes a huge difference on how you install your coil and how you pulse your coil. If it's stainless steel, you know, you can't go much over 30 watts, otherwise you're going to ruin your coil. If it's Canthal or nichrome or stuff like that, you know, you can have it cranked up or whatever, but I just really wish these companies would tell us what the coil is, tell it what it's supposed to ohm out to. That's all. So Oumier, I do like Oumier, so hopefully they're listening. Just put it somewhere. All right, and this is the Wasp Nano Unregulated SQUONK Kit in full effect here. Now you'll notice it's kind of got this kind of honeycomb pattern on here. I believe this to be resin, and then this metal right here, I think this is like an aluminum alloy kind of painted gold. This doesn't act, this is definitely not brass, because I've used this so much and it still looks brand new. There's no patina or anything like that. So this is some type of metal alloy, but it is a heavy squonker. I mean, this is not a light, flimsy squonker by any stretch of the imagination. You can see right here, that is where your USB goes, right there. You have Wasp Nano BF mod. Up top, you will have your Wasp RDA right here. Now, what's really cool with this, I'm not gonna explain this because I've already done an excellent review. Highly recommend watching it if you haven't seen it. My problem with the Wasp always was when I ran it like this, it looked really cool, but I got so much extra juice and spit back and shit in my mouth that I always just had a random 510 like plugged in there, and it was never matched or anything like that. Well, in the kit, it comes with a 510 that matches. So this setup right here, this thing vapes awesome like this. Up top, this is where your battery goes. This is 18650 single only, which does not bother me in the slightest, because you're running a single coil and I doubt you're running anything much lower than 0.2 ohms. If you are, then carry some extra batteries. If you put a Sony VTC5 in there, whatever, you know, you might have to carry one extra battery for the day. But anyways, battery always goes positive down, but it is unregulated. One of the protections is reverse battery protection. So if you mess it up, it's not gonna blow up our vent or anything like that. On the bottom, you see right there, it'll say designed by Oumier. And then there are two flathead screws. Take that off, you could take this apart. When it comes to unregulated or regulated mods, I'm not taking shit apart. Mechs, yes, this, no. I'm not an electrician, don't know anything about it, so I don't mess with it. And I don't obviously charge with that either. Now your fire button is gonna be right up front here. To turn it on, it's five clicks, One, two, three, four, five. All right, so your green indicator light right there. This will flash green if your charge is 3.9 volts or higher. Once it gets below 3.9 volts, it flashes blue. And then once it gets below 3.6, it will flash red until it shuts off at, I believe, 3.2 is what it said, 3.3 or 3.2. This is the difference between a mechanical mod and an unregulated mod. This will give you your full power the entire time until it shuts off at 3.2 volts, where a mech, you could vape this thing down to 1 volt. It'll never shut off, and you can feel your vape getting weaker and weaker, where this, it'll stay exactly where you have it until it gets to 3.2, and then it just shuts off. Now, up front here, this whole situation, I always love squonkers that have the window in the front. That way, if you're left-handed, right-handed, it doesn't matter, and it turns it into a one-handed operation, obviously. You know, you can hold it, squonk it, fire it right there. I don't have a coil in here right now, so it's not gonna fire. But this right here pops off, comes with one silicone squonk bottle. Very nice. You can see it has knurling both on the cap and on the actual squonker. So you have something to hold on to. Stem's pretty much cut, so you don't have to mess with that. Your fill hole on the squonk bottle. You got dropper, unicorn, chubby gorilla, whatever. No problems whatsoever on this. Very nice bottle. They only give you one, which I feel like that's kind of a thing now. I feel like last year we were getting two squonk bottles with everything. We were getting the hard, shitty plastic one and then the silicone one. And then everyone, you know, pretty much expressed their feelings at how bad those hard plastic ones sucked. So the companies now are just sending one silicone, which I don't like that. I think you should always have two squonk bottles. I mean, if they're gonna give you one, at least they gave you a nice one. Very, very, very easy to install. You can see right there, that's where it goes up to the 510. So you just, everything comes pre-cut. You don't have to cut any of this stuff. You just put it on like that. Now this piece right here, you'll see that's four magnets. Magnet, 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 magnet. Just like that, and you're ready to rock and roll. Now, let me just say this before we move on. If this whole thing seems familiar, you should probably look at my review on the MCM Underground Squonk, which I will post right there, because this whole thing is basically the MCM Underground Squonk mini. As far as the way that this front comes off, the way that this squonk bottle goes in, the way that the battery goes, the way that this entire thing looks. It looks just like the UDG squonker, but it is smaller and it is obviously much cheaper and it's not gonna last you forever. You know, it's just not. But this is one of the reasons why I like it, because I absolutely love Underground Squonk, and the Triple S's are, you know, right up at the top of my list for favorite squonkers. Vicious and Spades up there too. But this style of squonk right here, really, really like it. There's two other colors. There's like a more orange one and like a more bluish one, but this is the one that I kind of liked. They all come, you know, with your RDA and with a matching 510, which is awesome. We all know what the Wasp Nano deck looks like. If you don't know, you have been living in under a rock. Everybody knows this dripper. Everyone raves about it. Everyone loves it. So there she is. It is like the rainbow kind of deck with gold. And as you can see, if you look down on this, this is a 22 millimeter. And there is nothing left. Your 510 right there, This is a spring-loaded 510. It does sit flush like that, which is nice. This right here is the Pulse 24 RDA, just to show you. Yeah. I guess if you want to, you could rock a 24. Oh, okay. Look right here. This build on this is I believe a 0.11. Now watch what happens when I go to fire it. Red. So that right there is telling you that what they say this will not fire below a 0.15. It actually has that protection. You can see it's got some pretty beefy coils in there, but it will not fire this at all because it's below 0.15. Very nice. I can't tell you how many times that I've purchased unregulated squonkers that claim, or mods in general, claim that they have some type of a cutoff, and I'll put, you know, something off one of my mech tubes on there and it'll fire it. So this is true to what it says as far as its protections. And then to turn it off, 5 clicks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She's off. And that's it. So all in all, I think this is a very nice unregulated squonk kit. It's not like a cheap, flimsy plastic. I mean, this thing it's pretty beefy. You could drop this thing, it's not gonna break or anything like that. So, you know, I've done a ton of squonk reviews. Some of them been super lightweight, stuff like that. I'll just tell you right now, with the battery in this, you know, in your squonk bottle full, it feels like it costs a lot of money. That being said, I believe it is time for us to put this spaced fuse clapton in.
Hit it.
Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like me. But I gotta think twice before I give my heart away.
And that was some Limp Bizkit Faith. We went way old school on that, but badass song. And the Wasp Nano Squonk Kit by Oumier. Let's take it for a vape. All right, so pros and cons. Start off with the cons, end with the pros. We always end on a positive note here. So con number one on this, and I'm gonna keep conning squonkers on this until they start sending two bottles. I just think it's a con that you get one squonk bottle. I just think that they should always, you should always have two squonk bottles, because they fail. I mean, if you squonk the shit, at least for me, I have certain bottles that are my favorite bottles and certain mods that are my favorite mods. And I squonk the shit out of them after a while, you know, usually up around like where it seals at the top, it tears or comes apart. That's if you're using it a ton. There are plenty of other squonk bottles that fit in here, luckily. You can see it's got a ton of room in it. There's a lot of extra room there, especially in the width. Chances are you probably have a squonk bottle that'll fit in here. I just wish they would give you two, but it does. I think that ship has sailed, because I don't think this entire year that I've done, well, at least in the last 4 months or so, I don't think I've done one squonk that came with two bottles. I just think it's done. I think they decided that we all love the softer one, so they're just gonna give us one, and that's it. Con number two, you gave me a coil. You didn't tell me what it was. You didn't tell me what it's gonna ohm out to. This one came out to like a 0.3, which actually gives you really nice vape flavor. That being said, we're going to pros. Pro number one is gonna be, it's the Wasp. I mean, the Wasp is a proven, cheap, single coil that gives good flavor and can handle some pretty big builds, actually. Mainly because the coil is literally just right next to the airflow on both sides. I run this thing wide open and it's perfect. And with the 510 on top, there's another pro that they sent it with the 510. They listened to enough of the reviews on this RDA of people. When you didn't have that on there and you squonk it and you take your first couple of rips, you know, you get juice, you get a little bit of spit back or whatever. You put the 510 on there, no spit back. It might cut the flavor down a little bit, but I mean, it still has really, really good flavor. So pro on the flavor, pro on the RDA, the mod itself, the build quality, the fit and finish and all that, it's a pro. There's no errors on the machining. There's no nicks or scratches or anything like that. They even got the cool little Wasp symbol on the back there. I mean, they built a really nice unregulated squonker. Another pro is gonna be the size. Super small. Compare it to like the Pulse 80 watt. You can see it is much smaller. Then again, 18650 only, but I don't con that as long as it's small. This qualifies as small to me. I mean, in the hand, very, very comfortable in the hand. It's got the front window squonk, just like the MCM Underground mod that I believe that they kind of hijacked this whole design from. Not mad at them, it's a fucking badass squonker. So they did really copy the MCM Underground squonk. If you haven't seen my review and you watched the review, I was gonna bring it, I totally spaced it, but this is very, very much based off of the MCM Underground. Pro number, I don't even know, is going to be the airflow and how quiet it is. Listen. That 510 on there, it's a very, very comfortable vape. Without it, I don't know. I was never a fan of the Wasp without the 510. Louder, bit more flavor, but I'm getting juice. So it's up to you. Some people don't mind, you know, the little bit of juice, a little bit of spit back or like that, you know. It's totally subjective. But for me, this little guy right here, this 510, it's nice. You know, it's got dual O-rings on it. fits right in there perfectly. And that was always my problem with the Wasp, is that I only have like black 510s like this, and on my other two that aren't black, it just looks stupid. Without it, it looked really cool. With it, it looked kind of stupid. But now that they gave me one that matches, it looks pretty badass. Another pro is gonna be the safety features on this. They all actually work. The reverse battery, I tested it, it works. I showed you that it won't fire below a 0.15. That was like a 0.11, won't fire. I do like the way that it lights up on the side, because it does let you know where you're at in, you know, as far as your battery life. Once you get past green and blue, it's basically time to switch the battery. Speaking of the battery, 18650, I do like how they did this. Smoke makes a few mods like that, like this. I wanna see, I can't remember what mods it is, but they make some mods like this, some single 18650s with this same little cap like this. Button on it, it's nice and clicky. I haven't had any misfires. I've had no problems whatsoever with it. Five clicks on, five clicks off. No problems whatsoever. And the looks, I mean, I just think it's overall, for me, I think it's a really good looking squonker. You know, the resin with the kind of honeycomb pattern and stuff like that. It's a squonker that I'll definitely use. So price, what is this thing going to set you back? Well, if you are not a budget vape ninja like myself, then you're gonna pay like 80 bucks, 90 bucks for this thing, which if you do the math, you already know you can pick up the Wasp for like 20 bucks. So they're charging you like 60 bucks for this mod right here, which to me, way too much money. But if you buy it like I bought it, wait for the next holiday, whatever it is. I think it might be Labor Day or something. I bought mine on Memorial Day. It was a 30% off sale at Heaven's Gift. I'll leave the link down below, but I ended up picking this up for 50 bucks. So 50 bucks, take 20 off for the RDA, you're paying $30 for that, for this squonker, which is a fucking badass deal. So my advice, if you just want it now, get it, but I would wait for the 30% off sale at Heaven's Gift and pick it up. Now, I've seen it a few other places, but I mean, everywhere that I look right now, it's like 80 bucks, 85 bucks. For me, that's too much money for a kit that comes with an RDA that you could find at one point in time for like $14, anywhere from 14 to 20. If you paid 30 bucks for your Wasp, you got ripped off. That being said, I know price is subjective, but I would highly recommend, if you are interested in picking one of these up, wait for a holiday, wait for a sale. You know, what I'm looking for, Chinese stuff, random stuff that I haven't seen a lot of reviews on YouTube. I usually go to Heaven's Gift just because their prices, they always drop them huge on every holiday. That's my advice to you. If you just gotta have it, and you don't mind spending 80 bucks for it, it's all you. So that's it on the Wasp Nano Squonker kit that is not a mech. It is an unregulated, but all of the safety protections, they all work. Overall, I think it's, you buy it on sale, I think it's a killer deal. Everybody knows the Wasp. It's a cheap flavor banger. Can't really go wrong with it. This juice is fucking good. Like, just so you guys know, melon twist. Marjorie made me buy this, Lady Pal. And it's the same brand as that badass like pink lemonade stuff that I bought, but this is really, really good. It's a good summertime vape. So this, I'll leave a link in the description as well. I picked this up at Vape Happy, I believe. Yes, I will leave a link. But very, very delicious summertime juice for when it's 195 degrees outside in Las Vegas, Nevada. It's hot as hell here. That being said, thank you guys so much for all the comments. Thank you so much for all the subscriptions. We're back. We're cranking out videos this week. We're dropping tons of videos this week. I had my 1 week off, got regrouped, ready to fuck this shit up, so let's do this. Other than that, don't know what's going on out there. It's the weekend, but if you're watching this, then it's probably Thursday. Around here, in 196 degree weather in Las Vegas, Nevada, it's all love. Catch you on the next one.